It's AumSum time!
Do plants poop?
Huh?
Obviously. That's why I bought extra toilet paper for them. Nah. Oh. If we mean a solid waste coming out through an endpoint, then obviously plants don't poop. However, following situations can be equivalent to pooping in terms of plants. Firstly, a plant stores waste material in its bark and old leaves, and gets rid of it by peeling of bark and shedding of leaves. Secondly, some plants even store their waste material in the form of secretions such as latex, gum, resin, etc. Thirdly, at night, because the stomata are closed, the excess water absorbed by the roots cannot be expelled. Hence, some plants remove this excess water through tiny pores present on the margins of their leaves. This process is called guttation. Lastly, carnivorous plants like Venus flytrap catch insects, extract their juices, and then open up, allowing the hard, solid bodies, that is, waste materials, to fall off. Do plants get cancer?
Huh?
Is that even possible?
Yes, plants can get cancer. However, it is less often and different from the cancer found in humans or animals. We get cancer when there is a sudden mutation in the cell's DNA, leading to uncontrolled cell division, thus causing a tumor. However, plants get cancer when bacteria, viruses, and fungi cause infections, leading to uncontrolled cell division, and thus forming knot-like tumors called galls or burls. Besides this, in humans, cancer cells can travel through the circulatory system and spread to other areas, forming new tumors. But this is not possible in plants because they don't have human-like circulatory system, and their cells are anchored in place by rigid cell walls. Hence, cancer cells cannot spread to form new tumors. Thus, even though plants get cancer, it is usually not lethal.
Shush! Somebody's talking! Ha ha! It's the trees!
Beneath our feet, thousands of tree roots are connected to one another by fungi, whose roots penetrate and spread into the ground. They form a network called mycorrhizal network, through which trees send chemical signals and talk to each other. Big mother trees, called hubs, send nourishment to smaller plants, helping them grow. Also, a dying tree deposits its resources in the network for other trees to use.
Topic: respiration. Why should we not overwater potted plants?
Well, duh. It's because the water will overflow and make the floor dirty.
Nah. Leaves of a plant take in oxygen from the air present in the atmosphere, while the roots, being buried in the soil, take in oxygen from the air present in tiny spaces of the soil. When we overwater a potted plant, the air in the tiny spaces gets replaced by water.
Yikes! So do the roots know how to swim in water?
Oh, please listen. As air gets replaced by water, the roots do not get sufficient oxygen to breathe, and they begin to rot. This may adversely affect the growth of the plant. Thus, we should always try to supply adequate water to the potted plants and not overwater them.